to me, I say, help me. I want to say, help me, Jesus, oh Jesus!
Hallelujah.
Because if you call on the name of Jesus, hallelujah, demons tremble. They're scared of it. Glory to God. Jesus is not to be played with. And you know, and as you pray and you grow in the Lord, you learn who you are in God. You know, we can do things. We're not people that just have to come and sit, and raise our hands, and sing that song. You know, teach a little bit, preach a little. You know, but if you begin to seek first the kingdom of God and all His righteousness, you know, and you begin to read your word. Things begin to happen, positive things. Now that doesn't mean that nothing bad will happen to you. We have to go through things as Christians, just like the world has to go through things. It makes us and molds us. The tests and trials help us to become the men and women of God that He's calling for us to be in these last few days. But what I want to tell you from the bottom of my heart is I miss my words and the papers and I forget, and I might not say everything just right, but one thing that I hope that you take from this message tonight is that prayer changes things. And we're living in a time where we have to walk away before God. God is soon to come. The world where men are with men and women are with women should not be. But all these things are happening because God said that in the last days, perilous times will come. He said that, you know, no man will know the hour of the time, but He gave us a season, a time where things will happen so we can know be around that time. It's time to get ready right now. Yes. It's time to be ready right now. Yes. It's time to lay aside every sin that might so easily beset you. It's time to run this race, go into church, hear of God, see what He wants you to do. It's time to go into the highways ways to tell people about God. Tell people that there's a better way and that better way is through Christ who loves them. God loves us. That's what God is. He's love. And He wants us as the saints of God, as everybody. He wants us to love one another.
Yes.
The Bible says that they will know that we are His disciples by the way we love one another.
Yes.
Love is important to God. He wants us to love our neighbor as we love ourselves. You know, God wants us to be ready. He wants us to see His face in peace. Don't you want your name written in that Lamb's Book of Life? Don't you want to live holy? Don't you feel good when you're singing the songs of Zion? God is good to His people. God is good to His people. The Bible said, I've never seen a righteous forsaken or his seed begging bread. It's true. Every word of this Bible is true. And I often say that if you work the word works. Try it. Try it. There is nothing in this Bible that's not true. The word works. We have to pray. We pray and we talk to God and we see our prayers manifest. It's awesome. It's like magic, but it's not as God who created heaven and earth. It's everything. It's wonderful. I used to tell someone one time that still was getting high. Someone that's in my family, not here, but I told her, I said, I tried, you know, marijuana, I tried the hashish, you know, when I was 17, 18 years old. I tried liquor, that's about all, because I would say tight stick, but that's marijuana. And that's not a brag, but what I'm saying is, I'm glad I didn't escalate to anything like that. But I said, I've never felt higher than when I knew God loved me and His Son Jesus died on the cross. And then I was in church and praising Him, and the Spirit hit me. And I didn't know what it was, but that's the highest I've ever been. And I don't want to come down. But I tell you this, I didn't know exactly what to do because I never felt that way before. That was an awesome feeling that went from the top of my head to the sole of my feet. And I didn't know what to do. You see other people, you know, they're dancing, they're doing that, and other people are doing things, and you want to do it new Christian. And I felt this feeling, I was just standing there. And so I just began to, tears just began to come out, crying. I don't know what to do. I didn't, you know. And another time I tried to turn them down, but you don't have to do nothing. Just live right. Pray. Seek God. This time I've never before to the holy, you know. I can't say it enough. God has been good to me. And if I had one thing that I could do over, it would, well, one of the ones, there's a lot of things I would do over, but one thing that I would definitely do over is I wouldn't let him down. I wouldn't go on a stand again once I knew it. And I'm not going to go back there to see him. He loved me so much that he brought me out of backsliding, you know. He brought me out of backsliding. I was going to say something else, but I don't need to say all that. You know, I just need to tell you that God is a way to be. He's faithful. He loves us. Even when I let him down, even when we let him down, and we stay home, and we do whatever, or we do whatever. God loves us. But God said that all souls are mine, but the soul that sinners shall stay alone. And I don't want anybody to die and live their life, lift their eyes in hell. But I know just like God wishes for all of us to be saved. And we all won't make it in. I know that because the Bible says there'll be two women in the field and one will be taken and the other one left. I think that's in a movie where there was where two were in a plane and one was taken out of that. It was just a movie. But I'm just trying to say he was talking about the end time. One will be in the bed and one will be left. And I hope, I pray that none of you guys out there will be the one that will be left. The Bible says that they who hear my voice harden not your heart. Seek God where he might be found. And when you get to the house called by his name, you get saved or even before then, make sure you don't forget to pray. Because prayer changes things. Thank you.